Good morning students. Today we are discussing about nature or characteristics of marketing. Previous class we discussed market meaning and definition. Last class we discussed about definition of marketing and meaning of marketing. Many authors given many definitions. Marketing means majorly exchange of goods and services from point of production to point of consumption. It is dependent on a both mutual benefits. There is a two aspects or two parties. One is a producers and manufacturers. Another aspect is a consumers. So there is again two points. One is a physical system and mental system. Mental system means in point of manufacturers, they have to focus on a need and want of the customers, which products they want to produce, when the buyers ready to purchase, where they want to purchase, at what cost they want to purchase. This kind of activities they have to consider. In point of consumers, they also search about sellers, what kind of products they are selling, where they are selling, when they are selling, how they are selling. This kind of activities they have awareness about marketing. Now we are discussing characteristics of a marketing. First character, it is a operational. Operation means involvement in a transactions. Any event, any transaction who has involved, that is treated as a operation. Managers must think and act to achieve results. Here managers means in any business organization, who will take care of the business operations or transactions events, they are treated as a managers. Generally in marketing sector or production manufacturing sector, generally four types of managers will be there. One is a production manager, next sales manager, finance manager, marketing manager. They have to reach their results, they have to reach their objects. To reach their objects, they have to work, they have to involve in a marketing system. Benefit of marketing will not emerge from a passive attitude to the exchange process, emphasizing the statement, no gains without pains. We know they have to take pain. Pain means they have to involve in a different activities, then only they will get the surplus or profits. That's why we can say it is a operational basis. Operational basis, they personally, they have to involve in a transactions events. Second one, it is a customer oriented. Already we discussed, without customers, without consumers, production became a meaningless. Services became a meaningless. When a product are produced, somebody has to consume, somebody has to purchase, somebody has to use for their benefit or satisfying the wants, then only it became a meaningful. So majorly marketing is a customer oriented. Marketing form is to be the keen observer, focusing on the attention of needs of customers. First it has to focus on a need of customer, which kind of needs they require. Needs means there is a many kind of needs. We already discussed in a, you have idea about needs. A person having a, it's a infinity needs. One want is satisfied, another want will be arised. So manufacturers, they have to focus on a needs of the customers. It's effective lie in finding solution to the challenges posed by these demands. So not only finding the needs and wants, it is a challenging to fulfill their needs and wants. So they have to create the same time demand also. Demand means only want cannot transfer the goods and services from point of production to point of consumption. Demand means a person who has a want, need to purchase the product or service, at the same time he has customers to has a purchasing power, purchasing capacity. So this is treated as a demand. Next one, it is a mutuality of benefits. Mutuality benefit means here manufacturers and producers are also getting benefit. The same time, consumer also getting the benefit or utility. Exchange of goods and services works up persists because it is in the mutual interest of both parties. Both parties will get, both parties are interested in a marketing. Both the marketers and the customers benefit through supply of quality goods and services in return for profit. When goods and services are transferring or rendering or giving a quality product, quality services, they are getting profits. Here customers, by fulfilling their wants and needs by quality products and quality services, they also satisfying, they also fulfilling their wants and needs. That's why it's a mutual benefit oriented or mutual benefits. Next one, it is value driven. Value driven means the transaction involved in a value, money or money's worth. The culture of the marketing firm is based on a desire to build the business through meeting the needs and responding to the market, where the values espoused by firm leaders are communicated to all those involved in the firm. So here firm means total organization. Total firm is communicated with all those involved in the firm who are in a top level, middle level and lower level. The total system will be involved. So every activity is included a value based, or it's included a money or money's worth. Next, it is proactive to the environment. Marketing firm is a subsystem of super system, the environment. Here environment means we have to understand total marketing system is treated as a one environment. In that environment, this marketing is a subsystem. There is a many systems in a production and selling of goods from producer to sell consumers. This is a subsystem in a super system. It's not a main system, it is a subsystem. The environment is sometime which is external to the firm. This marketing is a external to the firm, not in a internal. The marketing took place external to the firm means business organization. The environment forces are ecology. Here many number of environment factors will be involved. Ecology, technology, competition. Technology means some business organizations use advanced techniques and advanced technology. Competitors, when a product is produced or services are produced, there is a many number of product or competitors, same product they produce. So there is a competitors in services also, many types of competitors will be there. Let's we discuss one point here. What is meaning of product and what is meaning of services? Products means products are a, we can see, we can touch, we can felt, that is treated as a products. Services means we cannot visible, even though it will fulfill our needs and wants. So there is a competitors. Physical resources, availability of physical resources also affect on a marketing system. Next, legal framework. Legal framework means production of products and services generally related to the legal system. Legal means every product should be homogeneous, not a heterogeneous. Services also, they have to supply homogeneous services. If we have any false products or heterogeneous services are rendered, there is a legal factors. Next, socio-economic factor. Socio-economic factor means economic system of the country, social system of the country, political system of the country also affected on a marketing, which are to be accepted by the marketing unit, where it to be proactive and not reactive. This is also one of the important character. And last one is it covers both profit and non-profit organizations. Profit, non-profit making organizations. First we have to know profit organizations, non-profit organizations. Profit organizations means its main object is earning profits. All business organizations comes under profit organizations. Non-profit organizations means which object is rendering services to the society. Its main motto is rendering services to the society. That kind of organizations comes under non-profit organizations. Marketing is not confined to only profit making organizations but covers non-profit making organizations or charitable institutions that sell services such as educational institutions, churches, temples, mosques, gurudwaras, hospitals, sports club and so on. Here business organizations, profit making organizations also they are involved in a marketing, and non-profit organizations also they make the marketing. Majorly educational institutions, they give advertisements to join in a particular institutions, charitable institutions and other churches, temples, mosques, gurudwaras, hospitals, sports club and this kind of organizations also they make the marketing. So these are the major characteristics of marketing. Next class we discuss difference between market and marketing.